Okay, thank you for coming to my presentation. My name is Daniel Adam. I'm from BMW, from the BMW Group of Research and Technology from Munich. I'm a PhD student from the University of Munich, and I make a presentation about standard Android apps in the car. I analyzed some apps from the market, not special car apps, standard apps. And how can you use these apps in the car? Have you many difficulties with the standard apps, or it's all okay? So first, I will present my company, the BMW Group Research and Technology Group, and after this, my research, my motivation, the setup of the research, the analyzed points, the result, and as a short summary. After this, we can discuss about this topic. So, the BMW Technology and Research Company, it's a sub-company of the BMW Group. It was established in the year 85, around about 25 years ago. And the task of this company, of this sub-company of BMW, is to research in the future, to shape the future of the automobile, of the transportation of cars or anything else. This target, we are splitted in six areas. The area total vehicle, to make new innovative body and driving dynamics for cars, efficient dynamics. It's very important for the future, but now already. Connected drive. Connected drive means active safety, driver assistance systems, display and control concepts, and driving simulation to save money in the development of a new car. A new car needs around about 6 years from the first idea to the start of the production. The next part is the IT drive. This is this area I came from, the connected car. New information and communication technologies are in the car, maybe consumer electric operating system or anything else. The next part is the Technology Office America. It's located in Mountain View, California. And the last car, the last part and the newest part is the Technology Office China. It's make more accessibility for new trends in the Asian area of the world. So we are around about 200 employees and 70 PhD students. In this company or in this area of BMW is the most PhD students in the whole company. So what are the automotive industry topics at the moment? The environment protection and energy efficiency. You know, BMW have new cars, new car concepts, electro concept with i3 and i8. Emissions reduction, because when you consume too much fuel, you must pay for it, as a company. Active safety and reduction of traffic accidents and new information and communication. So in the car company, it's called infotainment. It's the combination of both areas. So this means, for example, like Ford in the morning to combine consumer betrieb system smartphone with the car. But this is a current topics. The last topics are very large list. For example, the electric brake, active steering wheel, connected drive, new user experience, browser in the car, what are standard already by BMW, the head-up display, parking assistant for hands-free parking of the car, active brake, night vision, new control concepts, for example, our iDrive, who know BMW's iDrive concept? Okay, not so much. Good, I have after this a small video and then some photos. And many lots of innovation are already in the past, but we need innovation in the future too, to shape the future of the automobile. So this is my research. My research was to analyze current Android apps. How fit it in the car infotainment? So the main question is it possible to use current apps via existing BMW HMI system without modification? So why? Many apps are useful and fancy, are available, round about 300,000. But all apps mainly for touch control, and the BMW HMI have no touch control. So no, I have a small video to show the HMI of the BMW. Okay, you see now the current HMI of the last car, of the last released car of BMW. It's more like a keyboard usage. You have a strict order, you have a clear order. It's adapted for the car use. So maybe you can see at the moment the settings of sound. Or the radio. So it's not touch, it's only the iDrive controller. The iDrive controller in the center is very important for the car, for BMW. It's in the middle of the control panel, in the front. And this is the current concept and the concept for the future of the BMW HMI. So I use it for my research. I use a Nexus 7 tablet with a USB on the go adapter and the iDrive controller, the newest iDrive controller, because this is in the middle a touch area. You can put characters. It's a character recognition, for example, for the China market, for example, because they have so many characters. And a CAN USB converter to connect both worlds, the infotainment world of Android and the control concept of BMW. The software was the current Android version without modification. The setting was landscape and rotating locked. We use no special driver, we use the keyboard and mouse driver, the standard protocol, and all apps are from the Android market, no modification from BMW or from the original developer. So I make three different input devices for the test. The first one was the touchscreen of the Nexus tablet, because as reference to compare the results better. The text input was on screen with the on-screen keyboard. The second device was a mouse, only left click and a scroll wheel like the Apple mouse, no context menus in Android available, and the text input was on-screen keyboard too. And the main focus was the iDrive controller or the ZBE. It was connected like a keyboard with cursors. And the available keys for the test was the arrow keys, the return key to accept inputs, and the escape key to spring back or anything else to disappear dialogues. And the text input was character recognition on the touch area in the middle of the controller. So first, I compare the different input devices with advantages and disadvantages. So the touchscreen, yes, it's very flexible. It's very good. Everybody knows it. And the most apps or all apps are developed for the touchscreen. But touchscreens are not used by BMW in the cars. So the mouse has the advantage of free operation radius, so more apps are usable, but it's a very big disadvantage, the high distraction risk. So when you use the apps during the driving and you have a distraction, the crash or the accident risk are very large too. And so the BMW get maybe trouble with the insurance companies or with the regulations. So the last one was the keyboard. The keyboard had the advantage limited operation radius, but you have less distraction because you must not concentrate to positionate the cursor. But the disadvantages, controller orders, the order of the different fields are not always intuitive. We heard yesterday from Google, it's already concepts exist, but the most developers does not use these concepts. So this means a high distraction again. So which points are analyzed? I analyzed different points, four points for each app, and three until four different use cases. It's dependent on the app category. So the first point was the first start. Some apps have a pop-up at the first start to registration or input the different login information. So the second start or normal starts, three or five typical use cases, depends on the app categories. The accessibility to preference or future functions, side use cases. And the last point was personal impressions. For example, the handling of the app, the usability, was the focus always clear or so something not so the main points, so it means the side points. Okay, I take these tests with over 50 apps from the Google Store. Each of the app was analyzed with these four points and the use case, and the weight of the result was equal. The touch device was only for the reference because not all apps supported each use case of each app category. So I have a score scale of three different points. 10 points mean it's good, works as accepted. 6 mean works like with the touch devices. 5 points means impacts the usability. For example, the focus was not always clear. And 0 points get for apps or for points when it does not work. For example, some apps are very fancy and a fancy menu, but you cannot use with a keyboard. So this was a score scale. And what do you accept for the result of the three different devices? We have keyboard, we had touch keyboard, and mouse. Any suggestions? Nobody? So I have no chocolate for you. Okay, I think it's not so surprisingly for us. The touch device fulfillment, the requirements 100%. Nothing else. The mouse, yes, 100% in the middle too, but sometimes you get some points, sometimes not all apps gets all points. The lowest point count was 90%. But the keyboard was very interesting. The score range was from 100% until round about 10%. And the middle of the points was 50%. I think it's very interesting, but the details of the result of the keyboard are interesting too. So I split it in the different categories what I tested. I tested around about 10 categories from booking of trains or flights or hotels to read books, buy books, browse in the car, car stuff like speed control warning, delivery service, for example, for a pizza or other foods, a mail, messenger like Facebook, WhatsApp, music apps to buy music, to listen music, to control music, news apps to read the current news, public transport apps to determine when the next train leave, what are the shortest train connection from your current place until your destination, radio apps to listen radio in the car, over the internet, IP radio, social networks, Google, Facebook, internet TV, video. Video means local videos with the local apps and weather apps. So when you see the results, yes, the weather apps are very good. Not each app gets 100% the full points, but each app are usable in the car with the keyboard. It's no problem, but sometimes the handling was not the best. Mailing was very surprisingly for me, because all mail apps I tested you can use in the car with the keyboard. Car stuff, yes, it was already maybe the development for the car, but is an other point. The car stuff most of the apps have not so fancy user interfaces. It's more so the standard Android user interfaces, like from the SDK of Android. So it's make more fitable for the car, for the usage with the keyboard. The browsers are very get very low scores, only 30% the best browser, and the worst browsers get only 10%. I tested some more than 3 browsers. Delivery stuff have all delivery apps have round about 32% of the points, because I tested 5 delivery apps, but each delivery app uses the same backend service. So the user faces are always the same, but the start screen sometimes different. So social networks, I have a word spreading of the score from around about 20% until 70% round about. Okay. Have anybody questions for this results at the moment? Okay, I make a short summary. So most of the tested application work very good with the mouse, what we see already in the diagram. But most of the tested app work only very badly or not at all with the keyboard. The reasons are mainly created, the apps are mainly created for touch, not for keyboard. And the user interfaces are the most important problem, because very fancy and very sophisticated. But So usability is not so important, or is not the important point in the car. We have other points: safety, security, and regulations. We have different regulations. On the slide are three, or the most important three regulations. International regulation. All cars of BMW or from the other manufacturing companies must fitted with this regulation. So it's very important, but the usefulness of the apps too. When you look at the categories of the apps, I does not tested video apps, for example, to cut videos or make photo, or I tested not photo apps. I tested only usefulness apps for the car use case. So this was my presentation. Thank you for your attention. And I feel free now to make questions to me. Thank you.